السلام عليكم friends, I'm Dr. Mahdi Hashim from Advanced Software Channel. Welcome back to our SQLite Database Course Tutorials. In the last two tutorials, we learned how to create SQLite database and we named it as StudentDB. And this database included one table, we called it Student Info, and this table included students' information such as ID, name, grade, phone, age and image. And in the last tutorial we learned how to insert data inside this database through options menu that opens alert dialog. This alert dialog inflates a custom layout that include four edit text and image view, and when we click adding new student, this data will be saved in the database. In this tutorial we learn how to show the saved data in a list view. As we see here, we have only in the list view the image and the name. So we'll learn also how to show the details in another activity. But before we start, if you didn't watch the last tutorials, please go back and watch them before you move to this tutorial. And also I'd like to strongly advise you to practice. And if you didn't subscribe in the channel, subscribe now and activate the bell to receive notifications for the next tutorials. And if you find this tutorial helpful for you, just support us and give like. And okay, let's start. The first step here in the student database helper, we'll create a new method. This method will be responsible for showing data. So we'll write public ArrayList, and inside this ArrayList we'll create a new class. This class, for example, student class, and this class will work as a bridge of data, so we can pass and get the data from this class. And we'll name this method as getStudentData, and this method will not receive any variables. And here we'll give the permission readable, so get readable permission, and we'll initiate the array list. So we'll say array list student, for example, array list will be new array list, and let's create this student class. So here, and as you see in the student database helper, we have ID as integer, name, grade, phone, age as string, and image as byte. So here we'll write int ID and string name, grade, phone, and age, and for image will be byte image. Okay, and we'll create constructor for these variables. So right click, generate constructor, and select all of them, and also we'll create getter and setter. Generate getter and setter, and we'll select all of them. Okay, now the student class is ready, and we'll move back to student database helper, and here we'll get all the data. So we can write db.raw query, and here we write select all from, and the table name, and null. Okay, and to get all the data in a list view, so we'll need to move from the position 0 to the end of the array list. So here we'll convert this to cursor value. So we'll write cursor will equal to this sentence, and here we'll create while loop. So we'll write while and cursor dot move to next, and here we have the first variable is ID. ID is integer, so integer ID will equal to cursor dot get int, and we'll put it in the column index 0. And for the name, string equals cursor dot get string, and in the column index 1. And the same way, and for image will be by image equals to cursor dot get lob in the column index 5. Now we'll pass this data in the student class. So we write student will equal to new student, and we'll insert the ID, name, grid, phone, age, and the image. And we'll add this student to the array list. So write array list dot add student. And this method will return only the array list. And that is, and to show data in a list view, we'll add a list view in the main XML file. So we'll delete this text view and we'll write list view. And we'll change this layout to linear layout. And in the main activity, we'll define this list view. So we'll write list view, list view. And here in the onCreate, we'll just cast it. So list view equals to find view by ID r.id.listview. Okay. Now we need to show the data in a custom layout. So we'll create a custom layout. I created the layout previously to save some time. I named it show layout. And when open it, it just included image and name. The ID for image is sImage and for name is stvName. And we need also to create adapter class. So here in the package name, right click, new class, and I name it student adapter. Okay. And we'll give the extension base adapter. This extension requires four methods, implement all of them. And also here we write the context. So context, context. And we'll define the array list. Array list student array list. And we'll make constructor. So here right click, generate constructor, and we'll choose the two. Okay. And here in the get count, we'll just write array list dot size. And for get item, array list dot get position. And for item ID, just position. And here in the get view, so here we write convert view. And we have some work here. So now here we'll need to inflate this show layout here as we did in the last tutorial. So we'll write layout inflator, inflator equal to layout inflator, and here the context dot get system service, and here layout inflator service. So this convert view equals to inflator dot inflate r dot layout, and we'll insert the show layout and null. Now we can cast the image view and the text view in the show layout. This image view and text view. So here we write image view, for example, image equals to convert view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot s image. And for the text view, for example, stv name equals to convert view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot stv name. And we'll open the student class based on the array list. So we'll write student, student equals to array list dot get position. And we can get the image and the name from the array list through student. So we can write a string name equals to student dot get name and byte image equals to student dot get image. And to show this image in the image view, so we'll convert it to bitmap through the bitmap factory. So we write bitmap, bitmap equals to bitmap factory dot decode byte array, and we'll insert the image, and the offset is 0, and the length, so image dot length. And now we can show the data. So we write here TV name.setText and the name and SImage.set image bitmap. So will be the bitmap. Okay, now we finished the adapter, so we can move to the main activity and we'll initiate the adapter and the array list. So we write array list student array list and student adapter. And here in the onCreate, we'll create a new method to show the data. So we write, for example, show student data. And we'll create it. And here we'll pass to the method getStudentData through the array list. So we write array list equals to studentDB dot getStudentData. And this studentDB is the key to the student database helper class. And here we'll define the adapter based on the array list. So adapter equals to new student adapter and the context this and the array list. Okay, now the list view dot set adapter and we will update the adapter. So we write adapter dot notify data set change and that is now. Every time when we open the application, all the data will be shown in the list view. And when we insert new data, we'll just copy the method and we'll insert it in the here. So any new student will be shown directly in the list view. So we can test now, but before we test it, I added some students, so we have 5, so we can test now. Okay, very good. Now we finished the first part and we'll move to the second part of this tutorial, whereas we want to show the details of a specific student in another activity. So the first thing we do is to create a new activity. So here on the package name, right click, new activity. And I name it student activity finish. And here in the XML file, I'll design it. So I'll pause and return back to save some time. Okay, I finished the design. It includes image view and 5 text views, 1 for ID, for name, for grade, for phone, for age. And we'll go back to the student activity and I'll define these elements. So image view. The image equals to find view by ID r.id.dimage and the dimage is the ID for the image view in the XML file and text view the ID equals to find view by ID r.id.did and we repeat this. Okay, and we'll move back to the main activity to send the position. So we'll create list view on a click listener. So we'll write list view dot set on a click listener, new on a click listener, and we'll send this position to the student activity through the intent. So we'll write intent equals to new intent main activity dot this to student activity dot class and we'll send this position. It is here int, so we'll convert it to a string. So we'll write intent dot got extra, for example position, and here a string dot value of position, and we'll start the activity intent start activity intent. Okay, we'll move back to student activity And here we'll define the student data helper. So we'll write student data helper student DB, for example, equals to new student data helper and the context this. And we'll define also the array list. Array list student array list equals to student DB dot get student data. So we made access for the get student data through the student DB, and student equals to array list dot get position, and we'll get this position from the main activity intent. So here we'll write intent equals to get intent, and string, for example, boss equals to intent dot get string extra, and we'll get the position, and int position equals to integer dot parse int boss. So we converted the position to int, and here student array list dot get position. So everything is okay now. So now we can get the data of the specific student, and we'll show it. So for example, int id equals to student dot get id, and string name equals to student dot get name, and we'll do the same. And for image, byte image equals to student dot get image, and we'll convert it to bitmap. So bitmap equals to bitmap factory dot decode byte array, and image and offset 0 and image dot length. So now we'll show this data in the elements of the XML file. D id dot set text string dot value of id, because id is integer, and d name dot set text name, and we'll do the same for the other elements. And for image, the image dot set image bitmap. So we can test the app now. When it shows any student, it will show the details in another activity. We finished this tutorial, and wait for us for the next tutorial. It will be about how to create ABS options menu and how to delete item from the SQLite database. But again, practice for this tutorial, and if you didn't subscribe to the channel, you can subscribe now and activate the bell to receive notifications for the next tutorials. And if you like this tutorial helpful, so you can give like, and thanks for that. And again, thanks for watching.